Making moves, trying to get away from this life I'm living. Same old things every day, wanna change this feeling. Wasting no more time, don't care about what you're saying. Try to keep me down, no time for all your playing. Yeah, even if you doubt me now, you should know I don't care about the things you say.
Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my voice doesn't normally sound like this. If you're new here, hello, my name is Katie. I live in Orlando and I make like shop with me videos, pretty much anything to do with like Target, Home Goods, home decor, interior design, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, any type of shop with me videos. If you love those kinds of videos, definitely make sure you give this one a big thumbs up. And while you're down there, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my future videos. Like I was saying, if you are new here, my voice normally doesn't sound like this. I'm having a little bit of like allergies slash like traveling stress cold from being in Arizona in the super dry heat and then coming back to Florida with 100% humidity. My body is just kind of like, whoa. My voice sounded a lot worse over the last few days, so I waited as long as I could to film. So I'm really sorry if my voice is like annoying or off-putting. It's pretty coarse, like, or more coarse than normal. So I'm really sorry. I tried to wait as long as I could, but it was coarse voice or no Sunday video. Oh, getting a phone call. Be right back. All right, I am back. Had to answer a question about what delivery service had Panera, because if you didn't know, which you probably don't, I'm obsessed with Panera. I know a lot of people think it's like expensive hospital food, but I think it's delicious. Anyways, today's video is the second edition of Is It Better Than Home Goods? I did this with Old Time Pottery and you guys loved that video. So today we're gonna be doing it again with the At Home store. I have shopped here before, but it was mostly for Christmas decor. And to say that I was overwhelmed would literally be an understatement of the century. The At Home store is kind of similar to Old Time Pottery. It is huge. They have so many different sections, so much different decor, furniture, all that good stuff. So I'm really interested to go back today with like a fresh perspective and really compare it to all of our favorite store, which is Home Goods. I have a few other stores in mind that I would like to do this for, like comparing it to Home Goods. But if you have any other suggestions, definitely feel free to let me know down in the comments below or send me a message on Instagram. My handle is at Katie Vining. I always answer all my messages, and any recommendations that you guys might have would be amazing. But I know there's gonna be a lot to cover, so let's head in to At Home and let's see if it is better than Home Goods. This is cool. I just noticed when I pulled out the cart that they actually have a whole map of the store. So when you're pushing your cart around, you can kind of see where everything is. That is so awesome. Just want to give you a main overview like I did at Old Time Pottery. Similar to Old Time Pottery, right when you walk in is the seasonal stuff, which right now is outdoor patio furniture. What I like about this store too is they do break a stuff up by color. So they have these really cute little displays right here, which you can shop off of. And this one's all like sage green, which is one of my favorite colors. So definitely loving this setup right here. So similar to how they did with Christmas, all the front aisles are garden decor, but they're broken up by all different types of styles. So like coastal, and then this is more like farmhouse or transitional, a big like bee theme happening here. They have a 4th of July, more Americana outdoor decor, an entire aisle full of gnomes and other little trinket and figurine type items, a bunch of different lights. This one's actually pretty empty, but just more like little lawn gnomes and other little stones and things like that. They have some really pretty looking outdoor furniture. It honestly looks really, really nice. It looks like this was originally like over $1,000 if you put all the pieces together because it's a sectional, but it looks super nice. But these are actually catching my eye. These little rattan chairs. So they don't come with a cushion. They are $199 each, but they do look super, super nice. I feel like you would need to add a cushion, but definitely sit on it and check it out. They have some really cool options for like boho stuff. So $269 for this little table. Then they have this table, which is $199. And they actually have a little natural swivel chair that matches it for $299. So you could definitely piece together a super nice outdoor set with all the different options that they have here. I absolutely love this bar. It is $249. We're honestly kind of looking for something really, really similar to this. but we just need it to be hollow on the inside as opposed to having shelves, because we'll need the seats to slide underneath it. We want to have a bar table so we can look out over the lake in our apartment. And this one is honestly so, so nice looking. Seems really, really durable for outdoors. This is perfect. All of these sets are just so gorgeous. This one has the wood, but also the rope woven detail. I love that. I also love this little like outdoor recliner. It has this really nice like linen, but like weatherproofed linen that you would rest on. And I just love the look of it. I'm seeing a lot of clearance too. Umbrella clearance. I've seen decor clearance just on the outside aisles. So they definitely have a lot of clearance going on right now, and it's not like it's even end of the summer deals, but it says to look on the bottom shelf for 50% off. So I'm guessing the red clearance sticker means 50% off. I really like this little bistro set too, $249 for the two pieces and the table. That's really on par with HomeGoods. HomeGoods might actually be a little bit more, but what's cool here is that they like have stock, and they also have a website. So you can like order stuff and come pick it up, or you can come shop in store and you can always take it home with you. So I just feel like they just have way more inventory here. I want to head to the back of the store and look at the furniture. As I've been furniture shopping more, and now as I've bought in things that haven't worked out, I have a really good idea of exactly what we need. And I haven't shopped here in like 6 months-ish. So I feel like I don't know what they have, and I'm really excited to see if they have something that could work for us, because we really, really, really need nightstands. We've lived without them for a really long time now, and it's just not working out anymore. So I'm hoping that we can score in the furniture section. The furniture section at HomeGoods for me is super hit or miss. I feel like you only find one nightstand, or like you find a piece of furniture there, but it's dinged or chipped or messed up in some sort of way. And yeah, hopefully we can score here. So I just found this nightstand, which I like a lot. It's a really good size. It's not too small. It has a door as well as a drawer on the top, which is so nice. I really love the natural look of the cane with the fresh white. The knobs are bronze, which I feel like you could easily spray paint them black, which is something I would consider doing. And these are a great price. They're only $129. Here is a better view of it, like up on the second shelf. Similar to HomeGoods, At Home has little tape measures that you can grab that they keep like on the sides right here. I feel like HomeGoods has been out of these for months, so I always try to bring my own tape measure. They do also have tape measures there, at least at my location. I've only ever asked at like my specific home location. They normally have them like up at the little bucket in the front with the person who like is counting how many people are coming into the store, if they're still doing that where you live. But here they have these, which are super helpful because I need to measure to see if it like fits in the size of nightstands that we want. These ones are a little bit like, you know, they're not as wide. We're thinking like a 3-drawer dresser, but we'll see what Brian thinks. But those are a great price and they're a really good look. I feel like they are really similar to something that would look good with what we want to do in our bedroom. I like this two-tone slat door cabinet as well. They do have it new in a box that you can take home, or you can take it already assembled, but it is a little bit damaged on the top. It's giving me like spa vibes. I feel like because of the doors, it kind of looks like a sauna. So it's giving me like intense I hold towels spa vibes. Let me know if you guys feel the same way, but I do really like this. This is another one I like. The size would be seriously perfect for our nightstands, but this is on clearance. This is the last one, and I think it's like missing the hardware, because the hardware on it are like these really tiny, small little pegs. Seems like maybe a little like ring is supposed to go on it, but I'm having trouble finding it on their website. But that is seriously the perfect size. Why? This is a really cool wine cabinet. So it's like a barn door cabinet. So you can have it open this way or open that way, depending on if you want to show your bottles, or if you want to show like, that would be like liquor bottles and cocktail glasses, or wine glasses and wine bottles. This is super nice, and it is only $299. They have so many pretty like accent chairs and stuff too. This literally goes back and back and back and back, like tons of rows, like accent chairs, dining chairs, bar stools, and the prices are amazing. And like I said before, they have inventory, so it's normally not a problem if you need 4 dining chairs, whereas at HomeGoods you could find 3 and then spend weeks tracking down one more to like complete your set at another HomeGoods somewhere nearby. So definitely a pro for At Home. Oh my gosh, I love this. This is super trendy bar cart. It has the like rattan look, but it is whitewashed. It's only $149. It's like 2 little levels and it's on wheels, which isn't the most like aesthetically pleasing if I'm honest, but it makes it super functional. Just a little bar cart. This is so, so nice. I just love how they like categorize and organize everything, like all the different like neutral pillows, and they have aisles and aisles of pillows. So this is just a good way for them to break it up. So I feel like it makes it less stressful and easier for you to shop. These little accent tables are so cool. These little black and white ones, they have like taller skinny ones and then wider short ones. This one is $89.99 and the smaller version is $59.99. They have so many pretty outdoor pots right now too. I love how much seasonal decor they bring in. They always kill it. So it's nice to see that the summer is no different than what they had for the fall and for Christmas. Looks as though they are preparing for 4th of July. Most of their stuff just seems like they brought red, white, and blue stuff over to this display, and then they added like the flags and stuff, because this all looks like it could go for like a lot of different types of decor. Something here that I think is really cool are these little table torches. They're $10 and you fill them with the tiki fluid, which we already have, but it's just a little tabletop version to keep the bugs away. One thing I don't love about Florida is how absolutely relentless the mosquitoes are. It's really bad too in Massachusetts, where I'm from, because I'm from the coast. But I think here, because we live on a lake, the bugs are just crazy. But we love living on a lake. We see ourselves living on a lake probably for the rest of our lives, or on some sort of water, so have to take the bad with the good. If you are looking for these little like pinwheels and flags though, they have all different sizes for a really great price. These huge ones are only $5.99, and then they have the normal, well, I feel like these are maybe a little bit bigger than normal, but these are really nice quality for $1.99. Keep in mind though, you can definitely find all of this patriotic stuff at the Dollar Tree for a dollar, so definitely keep that in mind. The Dollar Tree is an amazing place to go for seasonal decor, for stuff like that. These are so nice. I love these pillows. They're like burlap. They are red on the back, and this one has stars, and then same deal here, but this one says USA. These are really, really nice. You could use them indoor or outdoor. They do say outdoor pillows, but you could definitely use them for both, and these are $20. A little bit more of 4th of July specific decor, this little box sign that says Faith, Family, Freedom. This is $6.99. I just love how they have it all organized like this. Another thing I love that they do are these little bedroom setups. So this is like a coastal bedroom, so they have like the knotted like sea rope little lamp and like little lobster pillows, a lot of like blue good tide only signs, a lot of like baskets, just bringing in the coastal like that, also with the nautical stripes. So I love that they do this here, because this is something that they don't have the room to do at Home Goods. Plus they don't have like continuous inventory. Like, you can't order this. If you find one, that's all that they have. So I just love how they set it up like this, because it makes it really easy to see how you could use it in your space. Okay, the next area I want to compare is mirrors. They have a huge section of mirrors here at Home, and I've been looking at mirrors a ton at Home Goods, so I kind of want to compare the prices of what you can get here versus what you can get there versus the quality of each. For instance, here is a 32 inch diameter black really plain frame. This is going here for $69.99, and at Home Goods this would be about $100. I am seeing it here in silver, bronze, or gold, as well as black, so they definitely have a variety of colors, and I would say this is definitely a better deal. Now, like, looking in the mirror and the quality of it, I feel like it is the same as Home Goods, but I will say the frame is where things kind of start to taper off for me, at least with the silver and the gold ones. The black one is pretty matte black, which is something that I think just looks really good, clean, and classic. So I would say if you're going between the two, I would check out here, because this is definitely a better deal. I really like this one. It has like a wooden frame, which I think is super cool. This is 30 inches in diameter, and I don't know, I just think that the frame is really, really cool. It is $80, so a little bit more than the other one, but also smaller. But I do think that it is more unique, and I haven't seen a mirror like this anywhere else, so I feel like that's a good deal. They have even bigger ones too. This one is 36 inches in diameter. The frame is really cool. It's almost like a gold foil looking frame. It is still metal, and I really like the look of it, and this is $100. Here is a really incredibly sized like standing decorative mirror. It's 24 by 70 inches. The frame on this one is just like a pretty like neutrally gray wooden frame. I feel like it would go good with a lot of decor. I'm looking for something similar to this but in black, and this is such a good price. It is $89.99. It is $89.99. I feel like at Home Goods for sure this could easily go for like $130. So this is definitely a better deal. They have a lot of different styles with those as well. They have like metallics, patterns, different styles of wood. But I just really like the really thin wooden frame. That's kind of what I'm going for. I just feel like the deals are amazing. Just because I feel like some of you guys might be interested, I'm just wearing a dress. This isn't like a full length mirror, it's sideways, so it's kind of hard to show you. Just has like a square neckline, puffy sleeves, and it's a baby doll, which is my favorite. I will try to link it down below, but it might be sold out, but I will try to link it down below for you guys. Just a really comfy, easy summer dress. I'm obsessed with the color of this frame. This is the mirror I just showed you my dress in, but this is the same mirror as like the gray one, but this one is smaller. So this one is only $69.99. I feel like this one is good if you're not planning on like just leaning it on the floor. If you don't mind like hanging it up like a foot off the floor, this is a perfect size. But if you want one that just stands like tall on the floor without having to hang it at all, go with the bigger one. I guess I should have waited till I got to the next aisle, but I feel like it looked cuter in the other mirror. Pro tip, don't ever buy a mirror that you don't feel like you look good in. If you're gonna buy a new mirror, you have to find one that you feel like you look great in, because I don't know, I just feel like that sets like the whole juju. Maybe that's just like me and like an issue that I have internally, but I think you should never buy a mirror that you don't feel like really confident in the store. Don't do it. Don't bring that negative energy into your house. They also have so many rugs and also like great rug clearance as well. I feel like maybe HomeGoods displays them a little bit better, but also not, because you have to like rake through them. But they have great rug selection here, and down here they have all these jute rugs on clearance. Jute rugs are like very trendy, very popular, and they have a bunch of these for such a good price, and a few of them are even on clearance like I said. So I feel like they have HomeGoods definitely beat in the rug department, because these go all the way back and all the way to the side. And also, I absolutely love this rug. I love the mix of like the neutral like grayish beige in there with the like more ivory cream color and then the slight texture. Love this. I'm still kind of thinking that Ruggable will be our best option with the machine washable rugs. So Ruggable, if you're watching this, please sponsor me. No, seriously, please. They also have like runners and stuff, and it's all broken down by size. So like 3x5 rugs, 8x10 rugs. So they just try to organize it for you, which is super helpful. I like this one. This is kind of cool. Almost kind of looks like a sewing machine like blew up a little bit. I feel like there's like bandana print and all these different prints kind of like woven into it, but just so many options. Like jute rugs on jute rugs. This looks like a pretty round jute rug. It is, and it's only $24.99. This would be perfect for like a front patio. Oh, I love this one. Don't be fooled. I'm gonna put this back, okay? Don't come for me in the comments. I feel like the prices are really good for these accent rugs too. These are perfect for under like a welcome mat or something to kind of jazz it up. Only $24.99, and this is actually huge. It's 27x45, which I feel like is really, really big for a nice accent rug. So if you have a big front porch, this would be perfect. They also have them numbered too. I just noticed they all have like a number, and then you can come right behind it and find the corresponding number. So it makes it super easy to find, because like I said, they have so many, and they do this for all of their different sections. Like if it's on the front, it's on this side. If it's on the back, it's on the other side, if that makes sense. Such great organization. What's awesome too is like, let's say you see this and like you kind of see it and you're like, oh, that might be cute, I want to see what it looks like. You can actually pull up all of the information on your phone. You would just type in B673 and it pops right up B673 and shows you what the rug looks like, gives you the price, and lets you know if they have it in stock at your store and they can deliver it or you can pick it up. Also found it in a runner on their website. They also like show you what pod to find it in, which is just super, super helpful. The pods are all listed right here. So it's just super easy to find stuff. Look at all of these other like little accent rugs that you could use under a doormat or like in front of your sink. They have them kind of organized by like style and stuff, but I just love how organized they are and how perfectly folded they are. They have like mattresses and stuff too. So if you need a mattress on the fly, if you have someone coming into town, you can come here and pick one up day of. Personally, my mattress is from Amazon. I can definitely link it down below if any of you guys are interested. It's really comfortable. I love it. It came super fast. It was like one of those like airtight ones that was like came in a small box and then it expanded. We've had a really good experience with it so far. So I can definitely link it down below if any of you guys are in the market for a new mattress and I don't know, want to see what we got. Another area I feel like At Home really excels is in the like fake plant section. They have so many good fake plants, great prices, and like all different types of pots and stuff. I will show you some of my faves. These are really pretty and trendy. They have different types of plants like ferns, and it does say on each one like what it is pretending to be. Then they have these, all different heights with like plant stands. I am in love with this one. It's supposed to be a river fern basket stand. The color of the basket is so pretty. The size of it is perfect. It's not too tall, not too short, and I just love the look of like the basket and everything. This one is also really pretty. So this one's more of like a vase one. This one is $44, which I think is a little bit pricey. Then there's this one, which is $69, which I feel like is fair, but still maybe a little bit on the pricey side compared to Home Goods. They have this one, which is $79. This more tamed fern looking one for $50. These more like big basket, like giant leaf fluffy looking ones. And this one is $90. They have this one, which is more of like a table arrangement. This one is $34.99. And then they also do have like trees. So all different types of baskets and different types of trees, all ranging in the about $100 to $150 range. Oh my gosh, that's my first spotting of fall. I'm not ready, it's not even been the summer yet. Summer's my favorite season, no, go away. Here is another example of a tree. This one is super tall, and this one is $130. I feel like the prices here compared to Home Goods are the same. Maybe here is a little bit more expensive, but I don't really know like how they do the pricing. Sometimes I pick up a fake plant and I'm like, oh, this is gonna be expensive. And sometimes I'm surprised. But you have to keep in mind too, like they never die. And you can buy at Hobby Lobby or online on Amazon, I can link it. It's like this spray that you spray on your fake plants and it helps take all the dust off and make them like stay really nice looking and more like realistic. I'll definitely link that for you. I saw someone else get it, so then I picked it up and I love it. So I will definitely link that down below for you if you are a fellow fake plant mama. Oh my god, I hate myself. Tons of options for like wooden stuff, which is really nice right now and very in. A lot of like mango wooden stuff, just these really simple paper towel holders for $10. Love this whole end cap of like all wooden trays, coasters, tons of different like serving platters and stuff. Let's see, this is like $20, $24.99. So pretty on par prices here, but just a different variety. Some more little serving platters. They also have this like mango wood boat, which is really, really pretty for $14.99, which is a great price. I love this one that says charcuterie and has the handles, and then it just says like different things that you might find on a charcuterie platter. This is also only $14.99. I feel like that is a super good deal. They definitely have a way bigger selection here of like throw pillows and stuff, and they're all broken up by color. So this is just like neutral and yellow, moving into pinks, blues, and reds, grays, and black, and then miscellaneous like teal, mustard, and rust colors. It's definitely hit or miss here if the covers come off, so same as Home Goods, you just have to check. As we all know, I only buy pillows that the covers come off, so just check. But they have a lot of really, really cute pillows here. The prices are pretty much the same, so it's gonna be anywhere from like 15 to 25 per pillow. They also have tons of little home decor trinkets, every single style you could ever imagine. There is definitely home decor here for everybody. I'm pretty much obsessed with all of the home decor in this specific aisle. This is really cute, something I hadn't seen before, so there definitely is some more furniture like hidden into the aisles. But just a lot of like really cute like boho stuff, a lot of like almost like desert decor, just like tassel-y terrazzo type items. I also really like those little rope woven lamps. Those are awesome. There's a fun basket down there. And then a lot of cool little like pots and wooden boxes. There is so much cute stuff over here. Like look at these vases or vases. They basically weigh nothing, so I have no idea what they're made out of. And this little jar. Everything is just so like eclectic. Oh my gosh, tiny. Here's another pretty little like two drawer cupboard. Hadn't seen that yet either. But what brought me over here was because back in that little furniture section, I saw these little coasters and I wanted to come over here and see if they have a little J. Actually, I'm not sure if it's a coaster or like a little ring holder, but I just really like the marble with the gold accent, and this is only $5. I'm pretty sure all of the stuff in this aisle is the At Home by Grace Mitchell line. This is still labeled like Winter Caravan, but there's not really anything wintry about it, so I'm pretty sure it's all the Grace Mitchell line. I'm also in love with this little paper mache palm leaf. It's so cool. It's only $14.99, and I just feel like it adds a lot of like really cool texture, but still is like super neutral but fresh. They also just have more clearance here than they do at Home Goods. At Home Goods, the clearance is typically really damaged, whereas here you can find multiple of the same item. They're not damaged, they're just trying to make space for new inventory. They also have a big pet section as well as wall decor. They have it broken up by like different colored signs, and they also have picture frames, more of like a children's section, and then true like wall art, clocks, and little canvas arts. Here is another example of like a little like room setup using all their stuff. This is a living room. I'm obsessed with this little drum table for $99. But I just love the way they lay out all their stuff, so you can like really see it put to use and what it could really look like in your space. What's awesome about the little room setups is that like it's right on the other side of this wall. So right on the back of it, they put a few of everything that they used in the setup in case you want to buy it because you like the way it looks in the way that they set it up. So when it comes down to it and we're really comparing the two, I will say I'm a lot more impressed with At Home than I was when I shopped it at Christmas time. The store was a complete disaster when I shopped it the other two times that I've been here, so it just made it a really overwhelming experience. Plus, I think because I hadn't been there, I didn't really know what to expect. So this time I was more prepared to make like a better decision on is it better than Home Goods or how it compares. So here I think the pros are that they have more stock and you're able to get like two of something or multiples or order something if they don't have it, and you're less likely to have to buy an item that's damaged just for the risk of not finding it again, which is what happens a lot at Home Goods. The cons are that I feel like they don't bring in new inventory as much because they have just so much of everything, and I just feel like more than anything the seasonal decor changes because a lot of the stuff here kind of looks the same. So I feel like this is a store that you could definitely visit like every few months and have like a really good time shopping around and finding all new stuff. But it's not like Home Goods where you can go there several times a week and always find different stuff because the inventory moves super, super fast. So if I had to pick, I would definitely still say that Home Goods is better, but I had a really good experience at the store this time at Home, and I will definitely be back. The last thing I want to mention as well is that I actually like this store better than Old Town Pottery, which going into this, I didn't think was going to be the case. Like I said, the first like two times I shopped here, I just didn't have a really great experience, but I feel like it's a lot more organized and clean now. I don't know, just like more stocked and less chaotic. Easier to shop for sure. So is it better than Home Goods? No. But is it better than Old Town Pottery? Yes. This is a fun series. I love this. Let me know any other stores you want me to do down below.
Alrighty, you guys, well, that is gonna be it for me today. I really hope that you loved seeing my tour of At Home and comparing it to Home Goods. The At Home store is always so overwhelming. They have so much stuff. The good thing about them is like they always have so much inventory, so it's like the good thing and the bad thing about them. If you love this video, definitely make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below if you haven't yet, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.